I don't buy new cars. I don't buy brand names. I go to Goodwill for my clothes. I like to save money. I like to find bargains. It's the life I chose. I throw nothing away. I'll find a use another day for all this junk I keep. My neighbors all hate me. They abuse and berate me, 'cause I like doing it cheap. Yeah, I like doing it cheap. Welcome to another episode of Doing It Cheap. This video part three is going to have to be cut up into several portions, several like 3A, B, C, D, whatever, because I don't think anybody wants to watch my fat ass for like 49 minutes. And I cut it as short as I could and every chance I could. But there are a lot of tools and labor-saving devices and ideas and interesting things that have come about because of this project I'm doing here. And what the project is getting this broken bolt out of this 6-horsepower engine. And it has proved to be a sumbitch, I won't tell you. It has been a royal pain in the ass. So I'm going to try to break these down in, I don't know, 10, 15 minute segments so that nobody has to sit and watch for an hour. And, you can see what the heck I'm getting into. But there is light at the end of the tunnel on these. So thank you. And let's get right into it. Well, here we are again. You know, we got to quit meeting like this. Anyway, what I wanted to show you here is I had been talking with some of my regulars and chatting back and forth about trying to get this broken off bolt out of the block of this motor. I'm sorry, engine. Damn, I'm guilty of it too. Remember, if it runs off electricity, it's a motor. If it runs off of gasoline or fuel, it's an engine. Anyway, this whole stud right here was a stud now. It was a bolt because it had a head on it. Anyway, it was stuck in a block, and when I tried to take that muffler off, it snapped the bolt head off. So I've been putting PB Blaster on it for days and days, days. And I tried to put my little pipe, well, I tried a pair of channel locks, but nah, they're going to slip. So I grabbed a little pipe wrench and I got it on there. And as I was putting pressure, I could feel it give, but it wasn't turning. So I was afraid I was going to split or break that stud off even shorter. I'd also like to point out to you that exhaust port does have pipe threads in it. Come on, automatic focus. There we go. There are pipe threads in there where a feller can just screw them a piece of pipe. But, Backwoods 82 found me the exact muffler I needed. Remember, if y'all been watching all my videos, you know that Backwoods 82 found me the exact replacement muffler. And this little engine, God, it's maybe 45 years old. It's been around the block. Anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to apply heat to this to see if I can get that little stud to come out of there with heat. And I just thought maybe you'd like to watch this. If it takes too long, I'll fast forward. But I want to do this in real time and just to show you what you got to go through. You know,
restoring a little lawnmower or anything is not just cleaning it and shooting it with a coat of paint. There's lots of times all kinds of little shit you got to do like this right here to make it nice. But it's one step at a time. It's not a project getting a hurry on. This is something I enjoy doing. So to me, it's not like work. It's just something I like to do. I like to take the way it used to look, and then it's all kinds of pretty again. And, you know, maybe my grandchildren can say, oh, man, that was so cool, you know, and then sell it, make some money. All right, well, let me get zeroed in here on where I'll be working, and I'll get my torch and all that all fired up. Let's see here. Well, if that hold right there, we'll be all right.
Okay. Oh, my wife says, why do you need that torch set? Why do you need all that? What's it for? I said to cut metal, heat metal. Well, why do you need to do that for? Well, sometimes you do. Oh.
I can't believe a PB blaster let me down. Dadgummit. So anyway, I'm gonna try to heat this thing without melting the dadgum motor. I don't have this regular heating tip. All I got is a cutting torch, so I gotta be real careful. Well, hell, right here on a wooden workbench, that makes a lot of sense, don't it? I got that rubber overflow tube. I don't want to fuck it up. Alright, that's red hot. Let's see if I can do anything with it. It ain't wanting to move yet. By the way, all the oil had already been drained out of this crankcase. That's why I can roll this thing around any position I want. Thank you. I think it's trying to come out. Lord, I don't want to break this thing off in there and have to drill it out and tap the threads and all that crap. But I think I was able to back it out maybe a quarter of a turn. It looked like that thread got a little taller. Oh, broke it off. Tune in next episode. Well, maybe it'll be a continuation of this one. Anyway, damn it. Well, I'll just have to save this file here and come back whenever I drill it out and use what's called an easy out to get this little stud out. I sure don't want to mess with it right now. It's still sticking out about a thread or two, so for me it'd be a few days, for you it'd be just a few seconds, hopefully. All right, so see you in a few.